हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक इन माय अनदर लेक्चर इन अ सीरीज ऑफ लेक्चर्स इन प्रोबेबिलिटी एंड स्टैटिस्टिक्स। एज दिस लेक्चर इज इन कंटिन्यूशन टू द प्रीवियस वन, सो हियर आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व सम मोर प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन बाइनोमियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। फाइंड द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट इन अ फैमिली ऑफ फोर चिल्ड्रन देर विल बी एटलीस्ट वन बॉय एंड एटलीस्ट वन गर्ल। एज्यूम दैट प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ मेल बर्थ इज हाफ, इट मीन देर इज इक्वल प्रोबेबिलिटी फॉर बॉय एंड अ गर्ल, 50-50, हाफ एंड हाफ। ऑल राइट, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल नंबर ऑफ ट्रायल्स आर फोर। हेयर एन इज इक्वल टू फाइव, सॉरी एन इज इक्वल टू फोर, नंबर ऑफ ट्रायल्स आर फोर। लेट स्मॉल पी, दिस इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ बॉय इन अ फैमिली, बॉय इन अ फैमिली, दिस इज क्लियरली गिवन, हाफ गिवन। इट मीन्स दिस इज प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ सक्सेस, दिस विल बी सक्सेस। सो फेलियर मीन्स क्यू, क्यू इज वन माइनस पी, सो वन माइनस हाफ इज ऑल्सो हाफ, दिस हाफ प्रोबेबिलिटी इज गिवन। फर्दर लेट एक्स बी अ रैंडम वेरिएबल दैट इन नंबर ऑफ बॉयज इन अ फैमिली ऑफ फोर चिल्ड्रन, देयरफॉर प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट एटलीस्ट वन बॉय, दिस इज द फर्स्ट केस, एटलीस्ट वन बॉय मीन दिस कैन बी रिटन एज वन माइनस पी ऑफ नो बॉय, वन माइनस पी ऑफ नो बॉय मीन्स एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो, बिकॉज रैंडम वेरिएबल इज इन टर्म ऑफ बॉयज, दिस इवेंट एंड दिस इवेंट, दिस आर जस्ट लाइक ए एंड नॉट ए, बिकॉज पी ऑफ ए प्लस पी ऑफ नॉट ए आर इज इक्वल टू वन, सो दिस वन एंड दिस वन इवेंट्स आर लाइक ए एंड नॉट ए। नो बाइनोमियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, सो पी ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू स्मॉल एक्स, दिस इज एन सी एक्स, पी रेज टू पावर एक्स, क्यू रेज टू पावर एन माइनस एक्स, यूज दिस फॉर्मूला, सो दिस विल बी वन माइनस एक्स, एन इज फोर, फोर सी जीरो, पी इज हाफ, हाफ रेज टू पावर जीरो एंड हाफ रेज टू पावर फोर माइनस जीरो, दिस विल बी फोर, एंड दिस टर्म इज वन, दिस टर्म इज वन, तो द वन माइनस वन अपॉन सिक्सटीन, सो दिस विल बी 15/16, दिस इज बाय बाइनोमियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। केस टू, केस टू इज पी ऑफ एटलीस्ट वन बॉय एंड एटलीस्ट वन गर्ल, सो दिस कैन बी रिटन एज वन माइनस पी ऑफ नो बॉय प्लस पी ऑफ नो गर्ल। ऑलराइट, सो दिस इवेंट एंड दिस इवेंट दिस आर लाइक ए एंड नॉट ए, दैट्स व्हाई आई एम यूजिंग दिस वन रिजल्ट। सो दिस इज वन माइनस पी ऑफ नो बॉय मीन्स पी ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो, बिकॉज रैंडम वेरिएबल इन टर्म ऑफ बॉय, नो गर्ल मीन्स ऑल द फोर चिल्ड्रन इन फैमिली आर बॉय, सो एक्स इज इक्वल टू फोर, पी ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू फोर, दिस इज क्लियर, बिकॉज रैंड इफ नो गर्ल दैट मीन्स ऑल द फोर चिल्ड्रन आर बॉयज, सो वन माइनस पी ऑफ नो गर्ल, एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो, वी हैव ऑलरेडी इवैल्यूएटेड, दिस इज वन अपॉन सिक्सटीन एंड पी ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू फोर, एन इज फोर, एक्स इज फोर, बिकॉज ऑफ दिस फॉर्मूला दिस विल बी फोर सी फोर, हाफ पी इज हाफ रेज टू पावर फोर एंड हाफ रेज टू पावर फोर माइनस फोर इज जीरो, सो दिस टर्म इज वन, दिस इज वन, वन अपॉन सिक्सटीन, सो दिस विल बी वन माइनस वन अपॉन सिक्सटीन प्लस वन अपॉन सिक्सटीन, विच ऑन सिंप्लीफिकेशन आफ्टर टेकिंग एलसीएम विल कम आउट टू बी सेवन अपॉन एट, दिस इज द फर्स्ट वन बाइनोमियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। नाउ कम टू द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन, लेट ए एंड बी, ए एंड बी प्ले अ गेम इन विच देयर चांस ऑफ विन आर इन द रेशियो 3:2, दिस इज गिवन, प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ए एंड प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ बी दीज आर इन द रेशियो 3:2, मीन्स प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ इज थ्री टाइम इन कम विद रिस्पेक्ट टू टू, दिस इज टू टाइम, दिस इज टू, सो दिस इज एक्चुअली नंबर ऑफ गेम्स आर फाइव, सो 3/5 एंड 4/5, दैट इज प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ, लेट्स फाइंड हियर, हियर नंबर ऑफ ट्रायल्स फाइव गेम्स आर, सो नंबर ऑफ ट्रायल्स आर फाइव, ऑल्सो लेट स्मॉल पी, दिस इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ विनिंग ए विन गेम, ए विन गेम, ए विन गेम, सो दिस इज क्लियर फ्रॉम हियर, ए विन गेम थ्री टाइम, सो दिस इज फेवरेबल आउटकम्स आर थ्री एंड टोटल आउटकम्स आर फाइव, बिकॉज आउट ऑफ फाइव प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ इज थ्री, 3/5, बिकॉज इट्स विनिंग थ्री टाइम, थ्री टाइम, 3/5, दिस इज सक्सेस, सो So that means small q, this will be failure. This will be 1 minus 1 upon p. So 1 minus 3 upon 5. So this is 2 by 5, and this can be also written from here. Probability of a is 2. Means he is winning 2 games out of 5. Now let x be a random variable that winning games. Therefore p of winning at least 3 games. This is given. We have to find probability p of winning at least 3 games. At least 3 games is maximum 5 games are there. So this can be x is equal to 3, x is equal to 4, and x is equal to 5. Use the binomial and density function for binomial distribution. This result. So in first case, any number of tries are 5, but x is 3. So 5 c 3. So p is 3 by 5, 3 by 5 raised to power 3, and this is 2 by 5, 2 by 5, 5 minus 3 is 2. Similarly, x is equal to 4. So this is 5c4, only x is changing, number of trials are same. So 3 by 5 raised to power 4, so 2 by 5, 5 minus 4 is 1. Similarly, next is 5c5, this will be 3 by 5 raised to power 5, and 2 by 5 raised to power 5 minus 5 is 0. If you solve this, this one for 5c3, use this formula NCR, factorial n factorial r factorial n minus r. Use this formula. So this term, this will come out to be 1080 divided by 3125, and this term after simplification will come out to be 810 3125, and third term this is one, and after this simplification this will come out to be 2433125. Taking LCM, LCM is same, 3125. So just add all of these. So this will be 2133. 2 18 20 2133. So this is the probability. This is the probability that winning at least 3 games, because maximum 5 games are there, minimum 3 games. So mean it can go higher, 3, 4, 5. Next is not possible because maximum 5 games are there. So this is the first two questions. Now come to the next question. Next is, in a multiple choice test consisting of 8 questions with 3 answers to each question, of which only one is correct. Means 8 questions in a multiple choice, 8 questions are given, and for each question there are 3 answers, and out of each 3 options are there and only one correct answer is there. Student answer each question by rolling a die and checking that first answer if he gets 1 or 2, second answer if he gets 3 and 4, and third answer if he gets 5 and 6. To get a distinction, student must secure at least 75% correct answers. If there is no negative marking, what is the probability that student secure a distinction? So first of all, see here, because there are 3 answer to options to each question, out of which only one is correct. Since there are 3 answers to each question, out of which only one is correct. That means, therefore, probability small p, this will be probability of getting answer correctly. This is probability of one question getting answer correctly, because 3 options are there. Favorable case, total cases are 3, and because out of these three only one is correct, so favorable outcomes are 1 and total outcomes are 3. This is probability for getting answer correctly for one question. So this will be probability of success. So failures, therefore this implies small q, this will be 1 minus p, so 1 minus 1 by 3, this will be 2 by 3. Also, number of trials, question, multiple choice are 8 there. So number of trials are 8. Further, let x be a random variable that number of questions for which answers are correct. Therefore, t of scoring distinction means out of, because for distinction, student must score at least 75% correct answers. It means out of 6, how much is 65? So 6 by 8 multiplied by 100, this is 75. It means for scoring distinction, student must score at least 6 questions. So this is called to p of getting answer correctly for 6 questions. 6 questions at least. At least. 6 questions. If he answer 6 questions correctly, he will get distinction. More than 6, then that is all obviously greater than 75%. So this will be probability of x greater than equal to 6, because maximum 6 8 questions are there. So this can be written as p of x is equal to 6 plus p of x is equal to 7 plus p of x is equal to 8. Now use this formula: ncx p raised to power x q raised to power n minus x by binomial distribution. So this number of trials are 8 and x is 6, so this will be 8c6 because of this formula. And this is 1 by 3 raised to power 6, and 2 by 3 raised to power 8 minus 6 is 2. Similarly, now only x change, trials are same, 8c7, 1 by 3 raised to power 7, and 2 by 3, 8 minus 7 is 1. Next is trial and x are equal, so 1 by 3 raised to power 8, 2 by 3, 8 minus 8 is 0. Which one? Use this formula for ncr: factorial n, factorial r, factorial n minus r. If you simplify this one, this will come out to be 112 upon 6561. This term will come out to be 16 upon 6561, and this term, this will come out to be 1 upon 6561. LCM is same. This is 6561. Add just one of these: 18, 20, 29, 129. So this is the probability that scoring distinction. So distinction means we have to check first of all, out of 8 question, how much question a particular person must solve correctly so that he will get distinction. So minimum 6 questions he can answer correctly, more than 6 also, 7 8. So this is all about this question. Come to the fourth: probability of man hitting a target is 1 by 4. This is given small p. This is probability of man hitting target, and this is given to be 1 by 4. This is success, it means failure. This implies q will be 1 minus p, 1 minus 1 by 4. So this will be 3 by 4. This is probability of a failure. Now A part is, if he fires 7 times, means in first case, here given n is equal to 7, because he fires 7 times, what is the probability that he is hitting the target at least twice? Hitting the target at least twice, because maximum 7 fires are there. So this can be written as 1 minus p of not hitting a target and p of hitting target exactly one time. Reason for this one is because we know this result, p of a plus p of not a is equal to 1. So this at least twice, this event and this event, no fire, fire exactly one time. So this event and this one, these are like a and not a. So this can be written as this one, can be written in this way. So 1 minus p of, use this formula, ncx, here number of trials are 7 and x is 0, nc is 0. So 1 by 4 p is 1 by 4, raised to power 0, 3 by 4, 7 minus 0 is 7. Next is NC1, this will be 1 by 4 raised to power 1 and 3 by 4 raised to power 7 minus 1 is 6. This one, which on simplification, if you simplify, this will come up, this is 1, and after this solving, this is 2187 divided by 16384. And this one, this term on simplification will come out to be 5103 16384, and after taking LCM and simplification, the whole term दिस विल कम आउट टू बी 4547 डिवाइडेड बाय 8192. सो दिस इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट हिटिंग टारगेट एटलीस्ट ट्वाइस. दिस इज द फर्स्ट केस. हाउ मेनी टाइम मस्ट यू फायर सो दैट प्रोबेबिलिटी हिटिंग एटलीस्ट वंस इज ग्रेटर देन 2/3. दिस इज गिवन. हाउ मेनी टाइम ही मस्ट फायर. लेट मैन फायर एन टाइम. सेंस गिवन. दिस इज गिवन. दिस प्रोबेबिलिटी इज गिवन. प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट एटलीस्ट हिटिंग टारगेट एटलीस्ट वंस इन एन फायर दिस इज ग्रेटर देन 2/3. दिस प्रोबेबिलिटी इज गिवन. इट मीन्स आफ्टर सॉल्विंग दिस वी हैव टू फाइंड एन नंबर ऑफ फायर. तो दिस इज दिस कैन बी ट्रांस 1 माइनस पी ऑफ नो फायर. No fire greater than 2/3 because this is just like a plus not a equal to 1. No fire means x is 0. X is 0 greater than 2/3. This implies number of trials are n. So n c 0. This probability is 1/4. P probability. We already evaluated 1/4 raised to power 0. And 3/4 n minus 0 is n. This will be greater than 2/3. 1 minus this is 0, sorry, this is 1, this is 1. So this is 3/4 raised to power n greater than 2/3. Now, which can be further simplified. Adding this this term both sides, so we will get 1 greater than 2/3 plus 3/4 raised to power n. Now subtracting 2/3 from both sides. So this will be 1 minus 2/3. Greater than 3/4 raised to power n. This is 1/3 greater than 3/4 raised to power n. Now after taking else taking reciprocal, so this will be on reciprocal inequality has changed. So 3 is less than 4/3 raised to power n. 3 is less than this means this term will be greater. 4/3 raised to power n will be greater than 3. So what should be the minimum value of n so that this term is greater than 3, exactly greater than 3. Now check here. Here 4/3 raised to power n. 4/3 means 4/3 is 1.3 raised to power n. Let's check for n is equal to 4. So 1.3 raised to power 4. This will come out to be 2.8. So this is less than 3. Actually we need greater than 3. Also, for n is equal to 5, 1.3 raised to power 5, this will come out to be 3.7. So this is greater than 3. It means, so on continuing this way, if you put n is equal to 6, n is equal to 7, this 1.3 power something power will be greater than 3.7, even greater than 3.7. So minimum value of n is 5. Therefore, this implies minimum value of n is equal to 5. That is, man must fire at least 5 times. 5 times, so that this will be greater than 3. Now, come to the next question. In a binomial distribution consisting of 5 independent trials, given n is 5, 5 independent trials, probability of 1 and 2 successes are given. This is also given. Probability of 1, 4096, and probability of 2 success, this is 0.2048. This is also given. Find the parameter p of the distribution. Alright. Since we know this result. This is n c x p raised to power x q raised to power n minus x, where q is 1 minus p. We know by binomial distribution. So this can be written as p of x is equal to small x. This is p of x. N is 5. So 5 c x p as it is p raised to power x and q is 1 minus p because we want to find p. So we have to convert q in term of p. This will be n minus x. Sorry, n is 5. Okay, 5 minus x. Where एक्स इज इक्वल टू 0, 1, 2, up to 5. राइट, सो लेट अस सपोज दिस इज 1, हैज दिस इज गिवन पी ओ 1 इज इक्वल टू 0.4096. नाउ फाइंड पी ओ 1 फ्रॉम हियर. पी ओ 1 मीन्स पुट एक्स इज इक्वल टू 1 हियर. सो दिस इंप्लाइज 5c1 p रेज टू पावर 1, 1 माइनस p, 5 माइनस 1 इज 4, 0.4096. दिस इज नंबर 2. ऑल्सो दिस इज गिवन पी ऑफ 2 इज इक्वल टू 0.2048. नाउ फाइंड पी ऑफ 2 फ्रॉम हियर बिकॉज एक्स इन दिस केस इज 2. सो दिस विल बी 5c2 p रेज टू पावर 2 एंड 1 माइनस p, 5 माइनस 2 इज 3. तो दिस इज 0.2048. बोथ सिंस ऑफ 1. PO1 from here and PO2 also from here. Now dividing 2 by 3. Dividing 2 and 3. Let's see. Dividing 2 by 3. Therefore, to, this will come out to be 5C1 P 1 minus P raised to power 4. This is 5C2 P square 1 minus P raised to power 3. And right hand side will 0.4096, 0.2048. Just two, dividing 2 and 3. This will be 5C1 is 5, 5C2 is 10, 1 P cancel, 3 power also cancel. We are left with only 1 minus P divided by P. And this is exactly 2. This is 1 minus P upon P. This is 2, 2, 2 means 4. 1 minus p is 4p. 5p is equal to 1. This is value of p. So this is the value of parameter p that we want to find. Now come to the next question. In 256 sets of 12 tosses of a coin, in how many cases one can expect 8 heads and 4 tails? Clearly here, number of trials are 12, n is equal to 12. Therefore, small p, probability of getting head in single toss. So this will be come out to 1 by 2. It means probably this is success. Probability of success or failure probability 1 minus p, this will you also have. Let x be a random variable that number of heads in 12 tosses of a coin. Therefore, we have to find probability of 8 heads and 4 tails. Now, random variables in term of head, 8 head means p of x is equal to 8. Now, use this formula p of x is equal to small x n cx p raised to power x q raised to power n minus x. Here, number of trials are 12. X is 8, P is half, half raised to power 8, and Q is also half. 12 minus 8, this is 4. And which on simplification will come out to be 495 divided by 4096. Use this formula NCR for finding 12 C8. Because this is for one set of 12 tosses of a coin. Because there are 256 sets of 12 tosses of coin. Therefore, number of, this is for one set of coin. One set of 12 tosses of a coin. Therefore, number of such cases in 256 sets. So, for one set is this one. For 250 sets, 256 sets means multiply this by this one. 256 into p of x is equal to 8. So, this is 256, 495, 409. 6 and which on simplification will come out to be 30.9 and which is approximately equal to 31. So 31 means set. So question is, in how many cases one can expect 8 heads and 4 tails? How many cases? Because total cases are there 256. So out of 256 sets, there are 31 sets which have 8 heads and 4 tails. This is for one set of tosses of a coin for one set, and this is for 256 sets. Now come to the next question. Out of 2000 families with 4 children each, means one family with 4 children, second family with 4 children, so on, this in this way continue, there are 2000 family with 4 children. How many would you expect to have at least one boy, two boy, one or two girl, no girl? Assume equal probability for boys and girl. So this is given. So number of trials are 4 here. N is equal to 4. 4 families, 4 children are there. This is small p. This is probability of boy in a family. Equal probability boy in a family, 50% chance there is either boy or girl. So 1 by 2. This is probability of success. It means probability of failure Q is 1 minus P. This will be also half. 51. This is given equal probability for boys and girls. So there is 50% chance. Let us be a random variable that number of boys in a family of 4 children. Therefore, P of at least one boy. At least one boy means this can be written as 1 minus P of no boy. And this probability is like P of A plus P of not A is equal to 1. No boy means P of X is equal to 0. Now use the formula, this one, ncx p raised to power x q raised to power n minus x. So this will be n is 4, 4 c 0, half raised to power 0, and q is also half raised to 4 minus 0 is 4. This is 1, this is 1, 1 upon 16. This is, after simplification, this will come out to be 15 upon 16. This is for probability that at least one boy in one family with 4 children, because there are 2000 families. Therefore, number of such cases in 2000 families for one set of family is probability this one, and for 2000 set of family this will be 2000 multiplied by 15 upon 16, and this will come out to be 1875. It means out of 2000 families there are 1875 families which have at least one boy. Second is probability of two boys. So this is exactly two boy, though this is nothing but P of x is equal to 2. Again use this formula. In this case x is 2 and n is already 4, number of tries, 4 children in a family, 4 c 2, p is half raised to power 2, half 4 minus 2 is 2, and which on simplification will come out to be 3 by 8. So this is the probability having two boys in one family with 4 children. Therefore, number of such cases in 2000 families is equal to 2000 multiplied by 3 upon 8, and this will come out to be 750. So it means out of 2000 families, there are 750 families which have exactly two boys. Now come to the third case. P of one or two girl. P of one or two girl means this is P of one girl plus P of two girls. Now, since we know that our random variables in term of boys, so number of children in family are 4, one girl means there will be 3 boys. We have to convert first of all girl into boy, because our random variable is in term of boys. 2 girl means there will be 2 boys. Now this is clear, this is x is equal to 3 and this is x is equal to 2. Alright, x is equal to 3 means, so this will be number of trials are 4, x is 3, 4 c 3, half raised to power 3, and half 4 minus 3 is 1. This will be 4c2, half raised to power 2, and half raised to power 4 minus 2 is 2. And after simplification, this will come out to be 1 by 4, and this will come out to be 3 by 4. So this is 3 by 8. So this is 5 by 8. 8 is LCM, 5 by 8. So this is the case where 1 or 2 girls in one set of family. So this, therefore, number of such cases in 2000 families is equal to 2000 multiplied by 5 upon 8. So this will come out to be 1250. That means out of 2000 family, there are 1250 families which have of 4 children which have exactly either one girl or two girl. Now last case, P of no girl. Now first of all, convert this in term of boys, because our random variable is in term of boys. No girl means all the 4 children in a family are boys. That means 4 boys, 4 children in a family, 4 boys means, so this is exactly P of x is equal to 4. So n, use this formula, n cx p raised to power x q raised to power n minus x. So n and x in this case both are 4, 4 c 4, half raised to power 4 and half raised to power 4 minus 4 is 0. This is 1, this is 1, so this is 1 upon 16. So this is the case a family have no girl in one set of family. So therefore, number of such cases in 2000 families is equal to 2000 multiplied by 1 upon 16, and which on simplification will come out to be 125. This is clear. So 125 means, so out of 2000 family, there are 125 families which have, or 125 families with 4 children which have no girl. So this is all about this question. So what we have learned in this lecture, we have solved various problems on binomial distribution, how binomial distribution, how the density function of binomial distribution can be applied in a practical problem. So this is all about this lecture. Thank you.